journey from being a really tragic drag queen who people told was tragic and was not very good and people hated, and her journey through all of her friends to become Newcastle's favourite drag queen. Sorry, Crystal. Newcastle's favourite drag queen and loved by tens of people. Please make some noise for Rhea Listik!
To my time. wow.
Are you exhausted? The poor thing. Oh, she does that peanut butter number, and just imagine if she became deathly allergic to peanuts right now. That'd be my throwdown in history. You would have deep reward for that. You would.
Shit. I know mouth to mouth, but I'm picky on who I do it to. Oh, and your cast. Look at the cast.
Look at the cast. Oh, my God.
If you're all here, who's in fucking Newcastle?
Who's working?
No, and we've got little Mogadonna over there. That little Moggy. Did you see Mogadonna?
Oh, this little Moggy. Look at him. Come and see this little Mogadonna.
Poor Shirley's Diamond.
Little Shirley.
Yeah, little Shirley.
Shirley Legs Diamond and Mogadonna had a baby
out there, bum.
It would be beautiful. All right.
Okay, you girls fuck off. It's just Rhea.
Yeah.
Hey, we've only got one spot.
All right, there's one spot, but we'll squeeze Rhea in. All right, let's talk to Vanity.
Well. Okay, so you know what? Everyone, that number was probably as long as other people's numbers, right? That was like a little medley, but that was done well. All the songs related to each other, you sold every number like cohesively, and you know what? You didn't get shadowed by your backup dancers either. You stood in the center and you were the lead of every single number. Being a drag queen, you're nothing without a fan base. And if you can guarantee, if we get you into the show, if you win or be a part of the winning party, and you bring this many people on,
we will win.
Then I'll put you through because trust me, these girls need all the help they can get.
I used to have that many people at my shows as well, but then they got sick of it. They got sick of seeing me do the same songs week after fucking week.
How many people were here on Friday when you and Minnie were downstairs?
Yeah, how many?
Nobody, because we never advertise it. Nobody knows, yeah. So you shut the fuck up.
We didn't advertise tonight either, did we?
Okay, you were talking about how many people were at your show?
Yeah, my show's fabulous, thank you very much.
Oh,
come on, right. We'll just go at the back while they saw
this. Go on, give it to Fiona, you drunk bitch.
Rhea, I love that. And the biggest thing I loved about that is that you've taken every bit of advice that we've given you through the weeks on what songs you should choose and how you should do it. And you've really thought about it, you've gone away and thought about it and produced this fabulous thing tonight. You were so well rehearsed tonight, you knew all the words, your backup dancers knew all their words. It was brilliant. Well done.
Chelsea. Really, yeah, I agree with Fiona. You look beautiful tonight.
And yes!
Not only is it good to see a fantastic show with your dancers, I'm sure you worked extremely hard this week to put that on, but you've got a beautiful fan club.
Yes!
To come along with you, to support you, and you're well loved, and congratulations, sweetheart.
So I went back and forth in your entire number because I think that was a beautiful number. You had everything that someone would want if they were to come see you perform live. And then at parts of it, I was like, I'm not sure she can really hang on her own without the dancers. And then I would just literally try to shut them out and just look at you. And you were living, queen. And honestly, watching you have fun made me have fun.
Realistic! Get your hood, get off.
Leave that for me. Oh, shit.